He is like 1:11, and we are laying on our bed in our room in London. So we made it.
Yeah, Islington, London.
Right.
We just got here. And the tube ride was like an hour long to get from Heathrow to the Islington stop. And then we had to walk a little less than half a mile to get here. But there are lots of nice shops along the way. And we are exhausted. Jill was falling asleep on the train and kept having, getting jolted awake. And
And can we show the room?
sure, yeah. Okay, do you want to narrate, Jill?
No.
No.
Just we are right on the street, people walking by, cars driving by.
Hopefully this room's secure, but and there's our desk there and our feet. And that's it. So our first solo Airbnb experience. Did our first little tour of the Benata. This is the first full day in the Benata. And a wonderful place, gorgeous building, but I learned something very important about selecting a site to go to. Because I thought that this is an art museum. It's not an art museum, it's a historical and artifacts museum. Interesting stuff, loved it, really had a good time, but I wanted some art. So I gotta do better research in the future, if this thing is going to be successful. Okay, so we're in Hyde Park and didn't get to spend as much time here as we wanted, but it's a beautiful place. We sat down in some chairs and got kicked out immediately while
They're
we.
for rent, they're not free.
Right. Well, we enjoyed a quarter pounder. Actually,
which we're embarrassed about, but
right.
we're really hungry.
As quarter pounders go, it wasn't very good, but
Yeah, it was terrible.
yeah, bad meat. But this is a lovely place. And a very public garden, just a gorgeous place to be. And we're enjoying the views very much. You have anything to add?
Nope.
Okay.
Attention to is the architecture, and I think right here by the Tate is an interesting example of just I'm sure you could spend years studying architects in London. I mean, if you just look at the building behind me, you know, that's I don't know, it stands out. And then I'm looking at these over here, which are apartments, and it's just I don't even know how to describe it. That it's just such modern architecture, and you can even look at the Tate building. And yeah, other parts of the city you walk through, and everything is so old. You know, it's been here forever. It's just fascinating. Sitting out here in front of part of St. Paul's Cathedral, which you can see behind me. That's going to be a stand-in for the National Gallery because we couldn't get a good composition over there.
and then we lost our opportunity, so we're kind of screwed as far as that goes. So this will stand in the National Gallery, which was amazing.
Actually, it's not in the frame.
What's not in frame?
St. Paul's.
Okay, well then it's not in frame, but trust me, St. Paul's Cathedral is behind me. And that's going to be a stand-in, even though you can't see it, for the National Gallery, which was gorgeous. The paintings in there are sumptuous. It's the tremendous art paintings, some Vermeers and de Hooks, which are favorites of mine, and paintings by Velázquez and a number of other artists. That Rubens, a whole room of Peter Paul Rubens, who it says was also a diplomat, which I did not know. I have to look it up on Wikipedia. But in any case, that was beautiful. As opposed to the Tate, which was a real tough juxtaposition. Oh, and our bus is coming, so I have to cut this short. Goodbye.